Well, it's the 4th of March, 1973, and we've got the English and overseas motorcycle riders, Ivan Mauger, Barry Briggs and co, and also Arnie Berg, the American stuntman. There's Arnie going up to the judges and the pit stand to ask when can he do his high jump. Bike boys are getting their mechanics are getting their gear ready for the overseas riders who haven't put in an appearance yet. But Arnie Berg's going to jump from about 60 feet high off the top of this derrick arm here onto that little pile of empty beer cartons. Let's have a look at it. This chap must have absolutely no nerves whatsoever, or else he's got marvellous control. He'd make a great motorcycle rider, I would say. Arnie Berg of the Los Angeles Hell Drivers. He'll go in a minute. He's at least 60 feet up in the air, look. He's on the way now. What a way to make a living. Well, after the water cart disposes of the fire, one or two of the cartons caught fire, we'll get some motorcycle racing going and the sidecars wheel themselves out and it won't be any time but away they'll go. Was one of the better meetings at Mystery Creek this year. This chap put on a marvelous exhibition of sidecar driving today. Takes all types, I suppose. Well, the Los Angeles Hell Drivers are getting themselves ready to blow the man up in the coffin. Let's have a good look at that one, too.
Any competitors down in the pits that wish to come and watch Arnie Berg blow himself up in a coffin, he's in the right place for it. Come and have a look.
Now, these fellows must be absolutely crazy. They tell me there's 16 sticks of dynamite around that coffin. Boy, they can have it for me. Well, it's getting very close. Let's see. Well, I don't like the look of this at all. This doesn't look... The Los Angeles Hell Drivers just got himself blown up. Wow, what a man. Well, the solos come out, Barry Briggs and his other three competitors in the first race for solos, and we'll see how Barry goes. He used to be a marvellous rider years ago, getting a bit old now, but he's still been world's champion three or four times. Let's have a look at him, Barry in red there. First man. lost any of his touch. That's Chris Pusey chasing him very hard on him. And he's in red. He's over three. They're getting ready to go, and it won't be any time. Let's have a look at Ronnie Moore. It's Ronnie Moore in red. Boy, these chaps were getting around Mystery Creek today. Ronnie Moore. He's coming in. Good wind for Ronnie Moore. Here we've got Ivan Mauger going out for his first heat. Ivan in white.
Shoulders up again, please. Shoulders up again.
Well, here they come, and Major's got the lead right away. World champion, speedway rider, Ivan Mauger. Well, let's have a look at the sidecar boys again. There's not very many of them here today, but the performance of the winner, number two, in each race was very good. Well, I've got them down in slow motion here. Fellows work overtime driving these sidecars and also being in the sidecar, so-called being in the sidecar. Teamwork between these two. Well, the track was in marvellous condition, really. We've got to thank Kelly Crow and his band of helpers for doing this. He had it in great order. No doubt about who was the winner of that lot. Now here's the team getting ready for the motorcycle jump over six cars. It starts off with a couple. riding a Yamaha, and away he goes. He just makes it look too easy. Let's have a look now. He's going to make it four. Now he's got six to jump over. Here we go. Marvellous jump, and that's the end of Mystery Creek, and so we'll say cheerio.